right, Chad. Welcome to the Fit Father Project podcast. It's my honor and privilege to have you here today, and I'm excited to hear your story. So to kick this off, I would love for you to introduce yourself to us, all the guys listening, you know, name, age, where you're from, a little bit about your family, and then we'll get into your Fit Father journey.
Okay. Well, thanks for having me, Dr. A. My name is Chad Beres. I'm a 46-year-old father of two, married. My daughters are 10 and 7. I'm a law enforcement officer in Wisconsin, have been so for over 19 years. And I got started on the Fit Father Project in January of this year. January 2nd, I think, was my first day.
So tell us, what prompted you to find the Fit Father Project? What's been going on in your life, like leading up to joining this program? What was going on with your health? Where were you at? How was your career affecting everything? And kind of what prompted you to join in the beginning? What were you experiencing at that point?
Like most people, in last year when COVID hit, I was doing double duty, working full time and also then being my teacher for my kids. And I kind of fell into that day to day and stopped working out. Really began to drink alcohol at home, which I never really did before. My wife and I generally don't drink alcohol at home. And it just kind of kept going like that and going like that from March through the and towards the end of the year or late fall. And I really, there was a lot of things going on in my professional life at work, just being busy. We're short-staffed like most places. And I just started doubting myself based upon my physical appearance and how I felt physically. I really started to doubt that I could help somebody if they needed my help. Like if I had to pick somebody up and you know drag them or whatever the case may be, I really started to doubt that I could do it, just based upon how much weight I had gained and what I felt like. And so during that time as well, my wife and I were having some marital issues. We were going through counseling, which was successful. Everything's going good now.
Nice.
And so all of those things kind of together, my lack of self-confidence at work and the marital issues, I've really felt that I had to take control over one thing in my life, and that was my health. I really had to start there, and it was just abrupt. And around this same time, it was kind of weird how things happen like that. I was, you know, mindlessly trolling through Facebook one day and saw this ad, and I recognized the person on the ad. It was a video testimonial for the Fit Father Project, and it was one of my pastors from church. And I saw him and I recognized him. I had scrolled past it and I actually went back to it and played the video. And prior to that, I had seen the pastor around church and noticed that he looked drastically different and he looked great, better than I had ever seen him. And I had talked to him briefly about, you know, getting control of his health, but we didn't really delve into what he was doing. So when I saw the video and watched it, it was like, you know, that light bulb went off in my head that, oh my gosh, this is what he's doing. I got to look into this because if it worked for him, maybe it's something that could work for me. So I watched the video and went to YouTube and started looking at videos and the website and just started watching everything that I could watch. And I really related to a lot of the stories that were on there and a lot of the pictures. I watched one of the podcasts with the winner of the body transformation and how he said that he noticed himself in a lot of the, I look like that guy and I look like that guy. And that was the same for me. I really related. I read everything I could read and I said, well, what do I have to lose? Because what I'm doing right now isn't working for me. So I just jumped in with both feet and signed up for the first 30 days and just to see how it would go. And it kind of just took off from there. And, you know, now I'm through, you know, almost through July and been going at it pretty strong, and it was the best decision I ever made.
I love it. I mean, it never ceases to put a smile on my face how different things connect in life. And we can say a lot of things about social media, not good things, but I feel very grateful in this moment that that ad found you at that time, happened to be your pastor, and you were able to join us. And in the first phase of the program, you know very well that we talk about mission statement and getting very clear about why you want to do this program and what you want to achieve. What were some of your motivations, and what was your initial weight goal going into phase one of the program? And tell me a little bit about that.
My initial goal was to lose, I think I put it right around like 10 to 15 pounds, because I didn't really know what to expect. So when I started, it was very, very challenging, like way more challenging than I thought it would be. I remember reading the articles and going through and doing, reading the part where it says you should do this mission statement. And I wasn't really sold on it because, you know, I'm really not a touchy-feely kind of person most of the time, and said to myself, you know, if you're going to do this, you need to do all the steps. I don't want to shortchange it or anything. So I went ahead and I did that mission statement, and I revised it a couple of times because I wasn't being truthful with myself. And so my major motivation was kind of a couple of things. Was one, to regain my self-confidence, two, to help out my family, my marriage specifically, and three, that to be there for my kids. My wife and I went through a lot of work to have all children. We had both of our babies, our IVF babies. So a lot of time and effort and money went into having them. And I don't want to leave them before, you know, it's my time to go. So the one thing that I can do to ensure that I'm there for them is to take control of my health. And that was my major goal. And that's where it started. And also the body transformation program, or the contest that was run towards the beginning of the year, that helped me out as well, because it kept me accountable to me. That's kind of one area where I've always faltered in the past, is accountability. And so I figured, well, what do I have to lose? It doesn't cost me anything to enter. If I win anything, great. If I don't, great. It'll just help me keep my motivation up. And it did. I mean, I was doing everything I could do, and I continued to do that. So it really helped me out with my motivation and helped me achieve my goal.
So Chad, take me back at the end of the first phase. What was the initial success you had going through that phase one? In terms of weight and changes, I want to know about your short-term changes. Like, what were the, around day 30?
I achieved my weight loss goal, if I remember correctly. I surpassed it by a little bit in that first 30 days. And that was like, it was mind-blowing to me at how fast the weight was coming off, and two, how much stronger I got. And the amount of time in 30 days, I was, you know, doing weights that I hadn't done probably since I was in high school. Cause I was an athlete like a lot of guys, and, I was kind of astounded, and that was, you know, even more motivating that I really have to keep doing this and to get stronger and see. Then for me, it was, okay, how much weight can I really lose? And, and also achieve what I want to achieve, which is just being healthy, a healthier version of me. And so I achieved that goal, and I just kept setting new goals, a couple pounds at a time. Okay, this week I want to lose 2 pounds, and the next week, okay, maybe 3 pounds. But I never wanted to shoot more than that, because I didn't want to. I've done some binge type dieting and whatnot, and, you know, not eating or eating no carbs. And all that ever happened is I fell off the wagon and eat a whole loaf of bread. And, you know, I didn't want to do that again because I've done it so many times. So I just kept setting small goals every week to attain, getting my workouts in, eating the right nutrition, and only, you know, losing a couple of pounds here and there. And if I didn't lose, I didn't really get bent out of shape about it, because like a lot of the guys in the face group say, it's a marathon, not a sprint. And that really hit home with me, that that's how I have to approach this. And I still share that wisdom today with guys that are in the Facebook group, that it's a marathon, not a sprint.
It's so true. I want to know what you ended up settling on in terms of your nutrition strategy. You read the Fit Father meal plan. You saw some of the principles, maybe some of the recipes, but ultimately, like all of our successful members, you adapted those principles to your life and your schedule in a way that works for you. What has your nutrition strategy been like? How has that evolved? I think a lot of guys feel like it's a daunting task when you start a new fitness program to change the food you're eating. You're used to doing these things and you established a new routine. You've done it successfully. So let's talk about that. What specific changes did you make? How did you really get a handle of your nutrition, and what works for you?
The thing that really worked for me, really hit home with the way my work schedule is the intermittent fasting, because I was never hungry in the morning when I got to work. I work early in the morning. I get up at 3:30 in the morning and my shift starts at 4:45. So I would bring something for breakfast because that's what you do in the morning, but I was never really hungry. So I would eat, and then I would go later on in the morning when I was out on the road and I had time to take my lunch break, I would go home and I would eat again. And then I would bring something for a snack and I would eat again. And I've always been an incessant snacker. I can never go in a room where there's food without walking out of there with something in my mouth. That's just the way it's always been. So I would eat a lot, and I think I totaled it up one time a while ago, and I was probably eating in excess of probably 3,500 calories per day, if not more, because, you know, cops like donuts, and it's just that's the way it is. And there's always sweet treats in the office, people bringing that stuff in. So I had to stop doing that as well. So I started doing the intermittent fasting, following that plan, making sure that my breakfast was the breakfast shake. And I have a couple of them that I cycle through to keep it regular and to keep it fresh. And so I do that. I really rarely snack between meals now, because I don't feel hungry in between meals. If I do feel hungry, a couple strategies that I have, I just chew a piece of gum, or I found these crunchy rice, brown rice rollers from Costco. They're just sweet enough to take that sweet tooth away. And it's only a 100 calorie snack, and it's brown rice. It's a good carb. There's no sugar. So those are the two things I focus on, or like a small handful of almonds or a small apple if I really need to. But most of the time I don't get hungry in between meals. I drink a ton of water. And then I just focus on eating a good lunch, which is generally either a salad or a sandwich, something of that nature. And then, like a lot of the guys say, that perfect plate, that is the be all end all for me. Just focusing on making sure my portions fit within that perfect plate, and that I have one plate and I walk away. Because if I don't, if I stay at the table, like when I'm done, and sometimes it frustrates my wife, because I'll get up and leave the table before the meal is actually done. But I need to get some separation, because otherwise I'll just sit there and keep eating.
They're easy to say that these are small changes, but they're not. You changed a lot of things you were doing. I mean, now you go into the office and you're exerting more willpower and saying that the donuts are no longer aligned with where I want to move with my life and my goals. At the table now, you're being very mindful about the kind of food you're eating. How were you able to make those changes? A lot of guys have momentum for a few days, but they burn out. Like, why did this stick for you in your experience? What made it so that you could pull this off?
I think for me, it was just coming to the realization that if I didn't make this drastic change, and yes, it's drastic, but a lot of the changes are so simple that I just had to think about, okay, what do I want out of my life and my health, and how am I going to get there? And if I can just do these simple little things and put them into practice every day, I'm going to get to my goal and, you know, keep the weight off and make it sustainable. And that's what I kept focusing on. And it may sound weird, but a lot of times in the office, if I see like a Kringle or a donut that's sitting in the break room, I will literally tell myself out loud, no, nope, can't do it. And I just keep walking past it. And I've gotten caught a couple of times saying that to myself by other people, and they look at me like I'm crazy. But I mean, that's what I have to do, because if I don't do that, I'll probably, it'll get the better of me, because I have to walk past that area several times throughout the course of my day. So it's just finding something that worked for me, and that's what works for me. I constantly tell myself no, or got to be done, or you got to get up from the table, or, you know, those are the things that work for me.
What you're describing is you're putting up guardrails through powerful decisions, and you're doing it on a regular basis. I think something I really love that you're sharing is it's not like you're never going to see these temptations or treats again. You're going into work, they're going to be there, but you have an actual system that is even verbalized to the point of saying no out loud, that when those situations come up, it's easier to say no, make that powerful decision. You're kind of also, at least on some level of conscious awareness, you're reaffirming your decision that you're a fit father, you know, that you're a guy who's living in this way. And I think that's amazing. Tell us some more about other aspects of your plan, your exercising. Let's talk a little bit about your workouts, what has worked for you and other things you noticed. You were mentioning that you were shocked at how much stronger you got in nearly 30 days of the Apex 10 and the other kind of workouts in phase one. Let's talk about your exercise, and then I want to keep on going through the story.
What I really focused on and what I found super simple was that all of the workouts from the start, from Apex 10 and then throughout all the other phases, is that the workouts are there. The videos are there. So all of that's, and that's way different than other programs that I've tried. Generally, it's like a PDF or a book with some pictures of and description about how to do exercises. But having those videos is hands down one of the most valuable things, because you can look at what proper form is and things of that nature. So I found that sticking to the layout, the workout layout that was in the material, was key for me, because it took all the guesswork out of what am I going to do today. And that's where I've struggled in the past as well, is trying to figure out what am I going to do. You know, am I going to do cardio today, or am I going to do whatever? And just following that layout was key. You know, today is this workout. Today is Apex 10, and okay, I gotta get tomorrow is my hit day, and you know, so I just followed that throughout every phase. I followed the calendar layout, and if I had to tweak it here and there, I did. And if my schedule didn't allow a workout, I started out really good. I didn't miss a workout for, I bet you, 60 days. I didn't miss one workout.
And then I
did, because of life, and I didn't dwell on it. You know, it happens and you just keep on going. And that's the same with my nutrition. Am I perfect? No, far from it. I falter. You know, we camp a lot, especially this time of year, and camping food is awesome. And, you know, did I have a s'more? Sure. Did I feel guilty about it? Not in the least. It was awesome. Did it make me feel weird? Yeah, because I was eating something like a lot of sugar that I haven't had before. And it was like, I don't know, the first sugar I ever had. I felt like my heart was going to explode. It was just crazy. But, you know, that's just, you know, the things that I found that work for me is just following the plan, and having that layout is just, it's invaluable.
I have to laugh for a couple of reasons, and I want to dig into this a little more. As I too went camping recently, had a s'more, and experienced the exact same thing you described. And it's fun when your body cleans up and gets in a cleaner running system. When you put the old stuff in that you might have had regularly, it's like the system reacts and you learn a lot about your body. What fascinates me is but when you were starting out your story, you were telling us how, as a police officer, you were even questioning your ability to really show up because physically you knew you weren't there. And now you've gone through these workouts. And for those who don't know, the workouts are intense. You know, they definitely challenge you and push you. What is the change been, the net change in your body been in your relationship to your body, your confidence in your body, the kinds of things you can now do physically? And also I want to know, when did you find the time to exercise? How did you go from not doing these kinds of workouts to getting in your schedule? So let's dive into some more of those specifics.
What I had to do is really examine what time I have available, because, you know, my wife and I both work full time. I get done with work at 1:15 in the afternoon if I get done on time, and I pick up my kids when it's school year. I pick them up at 3:40. So I'm like, well, it might not be a lot of time between then, but I have enough time that I can get my workout in between work and picking up my kids. So my routine, and I follow it to this day, is I get home from work. The only time I sit down is to change my shoes. I quickly put on my workout clothes. And if my wife is working from home, I don't even say hi to her. A lot of times she doesn't even know that I'm home. I change as quickly as I can, and I get downstairs into my gym in my basement, and I get my workout in. And when I'm done, I have generally enough time to, you know, make my shake and or eat my post-workout meal, and then I go pick up my kids and march on with the rest of my day. And that's what works for me, is just finding the time that I have available. And if it doesn't work out that way, if I don't get done on time, well, then I just try to get it in later in the day. Sometimes I have to wait until like an hour or two before bed, but I get it in one way or the other.
That is what you just shared, I think, is an absolute keystone in your routine. So a couple things we talk about in the program that you're very familiar with is, one, with your nutrition, you find the meal timing schedule setup that works for you. You found intermittent fastingmassively good. You got that keystone locked in. And then you also found your sacred workout time, in the sense that, you know, you have this window and that's the place you get it done. And that seems to me the key, that you have this window and that you carved it out and created it, is why you go 60 days strong on working out. Obviously you miss a day sometimes, but that's really, really important that you have that. And that's awesome. So how has your body changed now that you're doing some of the advanced workouts, let's say in the end of phase three, into phase four, you're doing all these other workouts. How has your fitness changed? And what's it been like doing these kinds of Fit Father workouts?
They are very challenging, especially now I'm in phase four. I probably will do old school muscle at some point in time. But right now I'm focusing on maintaining and just kind of working it out. And the reason why I wanted to do that is to really solidify what I've learned and to put it into practice, mm-hmm. because there's so much freedom with phase four to, you know, go back to mm-hmm. past workouts and really play around with, you know, revisiting stuff and what works for you. So I'm enjoying that now. And I look back, because I have a binder, and I look back at past workouts to see, okay, on this date, which was several months ago, I did this weight and it took me this long. Well, let's up the weight and see if I can get it done faster, focusing on proper form and things like that. But, you know, I'm constantly trying to challenge myself to do a little bit more, and it's paid off. At the lowest point I got, I lost like 47 pounds, and I'm wearing a 32 duty belt, which I've never worn in my career ever. And people at work, at first they didn't know, because we wear a vest and it kind of makes everybody look bulky. Yeah. But when I take it off, they see me, and it's funny. I'll share a small story. Last 2 weeks ago, I passed one of our custodial staff in the hallway, and we passed each other. We said good morning. And then she said, "What are you doing?" And I didn't know if she was talking to me, because we were past each other already. So I stopped and I turned around and I said, "Are you talking to me?" And she said, "Yes." She said, "What have you been doing? You have lost a ton of weight." And I told her what I was doing. I told her about the Fit Father Project and about Fit Mother. And we got to talking about it. And she, I told my wife this too, and she chuckled. The custodial lady called me beautiful. And I laughed like you wouldn't believe. I said, "I don't think I've ever been called beautiful. I don't think that's anything that anybody's ever said to me." So it made me chuckle. But, you know, she was very interested in the program. And so I went on the website and I gifted it to her in hopes that, you know, that she'll take advantage of it because she has some knowledge that she wants.
That's amazing. It's super special that you're able to take your transformation and kind of just be, I think of it almost like a flame. You're a candle out in your community, and someone sees that, they get inspired, and I hope she catches fire and does the same for some of her family. So have things changed with your kids and your family, other benefits of the program outside of increased, you know, all the things we've discussed about, any other domains of your life that this has been meaningful for?
My relationship with my kids is better just because I have more energy to do things with them. I don't feel like, oh, I can't go out and play soccer because, you know, my knees are going to be sore. They might be, but, you know, that's not because I'm out of shape. It's just because, you know, I'm an older guy. And so I just get sore for different things. But I have that energy where before I was like, you know, I don't want to go outside and play soccer because I am going to be sore. And now I don't care if I'm sore because I'm spending time with my kids. We've always been an active family. We have, our kids are in a ton of activities, and, you know, I like to do that stuff with them, whatever it is. And I just have more energy to do that. And, you know, they see that I've lost weight. I've actually had them downstairs with me in the gym. Sometimes they want to work out with me. Sometimes they don't. Sometimes they'll just come down and I'll say, "Okay, I have to do 10 reps of this exercise. Can you count them for me?" And they do. They'll count my reps, and then they're, "Okay, what do you got to do next?" And we move on to the next thing. They like it. They think it's funny. They just don't like to see me sweat like I do.
Oh yeah, for sure. The Fit Father workouts infamously sweaty, right? You got sweat angels on the floor. Looks like someone died in your basement.
Yep.
Just your fat melting away. Pool of tears. I love it. So anything else you'd like to share? I mean, your story is incredible and all that we've covered. Any advice maybe you have for new guys starting out? Any advice for guys who are at the stage where you're at right now in the journey, which is, you know, sustaining cruise control, but also like thinking about what's next and solidifying all the transformation? You know, I'd love for you to share some words of wisdom for us to close this out.
I think for new people just starting out in the program, really, really take advantage of examining yourself and why you want to start this program, and do the mission statement. And don't just do it once and put it away. I actually tape mine up in my gym because I look at it. And I've revised it a couple of times because, you know, as time goes by, your goals might change. So I revise it from time to time, and I constantly look at it just to remind myself on why I started and where I want to go. Another thing, you know, if you're not on social media, it makes it kind of hard. But if you are on social media, take advantage of that, of the Brotherhood Facebook group. It is awesome. And I've done several different programs throughout the course of years. And this is the first one where I've actually, you know, shared stuff with guys, or shared my workouts, or had a question and asked it. And so that platform is awesome because you realize that, you know, this person you might be corresponding with is from Canada, or is from Great Britain, or wherever, and their struggles are the same as your struggles. They might not be completely the same, but you're struggling with something. And so you quickly realize that we're all in the same boat, and we all have our goals, whatever they are. And you got to lean on somebody And so why not lean on somebody that, you know, is going through the same thing or has gone through the same thing and might have some good information? And that's what I do. And your question and answer phases that Ben does on Fridays, those are hands down like another really awesome thing, because you have questions as you go throughout this program and he answers them. And then some. I continue to watch the Friday questions, because every now and again that you need a reminder, or there'll be another question that you didn't think of. So just doing all of those things and just being active in your progression is only going to help you.
A beautiful answer. And I'm so happy that you took advantage of the group. It's amazing. It's one of my favorite things is, you know, we all, you're right. We're all in this together, 110%. What is it for you in your future? In closing, you're on this Fit Father journey. You've recreated yourself. Goals and aspirations for the next 5-10 years with your fitness. What would you like to accomplish next?
I would like to help as many people as I can. One through just, you know, if something that I say struck a chord with you and can inspire anybody, that's awesome. I mean, that's, you know, what I hope to do. I'd like to get involved in possibly personal training. I've toyed around with that for a couple of years, because I used to be really active. I mean, I've always been active, but back before I had kids, I was a pretty regular triathlete. I did the Wisconsin Ironman. I've done a lot of really grueling physical things in my time, and I'd like to get back into triathlon and possibly try to compete, or at least qualify, not qualify, but at least go to Kona for the Ironman World Championships. Yeah. That's been on my bucket list for years. I'm just not fast enough to get there for qualification. Now I'm getting back into a lot of the stuff that I've loved for years, bicycling. That's like one of my passions is cycling. So I'm on my bike quite a bit. So, I mean, I just want to keep doing those things and just paying it forward in whatever way that I can. I'm trying to talk my brother into starting. I actually had him read the initial material, and hasn't quite started working out yet because he's got some physical limitations that he's working on, but he started intermittent fasting as well, and his weight is coming off strictly by dieting. There's a couple of my really close high school friends that I've met up with. They asked me about the program, and for lack of a better term, I push the product as much as I can because I believe in it. It worked for me, and I think it's probably the best program out there, especially for people that have a busy lifestyle. And so I just want to help as many people as I can and just keep pushing myself to be healthy and live longer than your average cop lives after he retires. So that's my goal.
You're absolutely doing it. And I mean, this right here, can't wait to get this podcast out to share your message. You're impacting lives. You're doing it in the Brotherhood group. And it brings me great joy that at 46 years young, your passion for movement and your dreams and aspirations with your body are now like on fire again. And I hope that you do go to Kona and enjoy that. You're an awesome guy, Chad. Definitely inspire me. You're a fit father through and through. I appreciate you coming on. I can't wait to share this with the brothers.